I sell here. So next year is very important for Samsung as it's a transitional period for their Exynos team, as the next generation Exynos processor will move away from custom M cores to stock cores from ARM. Now, the first Exynos chipset to see this change is confirmed by none other than the director of Samsung China R&D Institute. He revealed that Exynos 1080 is going to be the successor to the Exynos 980, which was seen on devices like the Galaxy A71, A51 5G and more. For some clarity, Exynos 980 is equivalent to Snapdragon 765. So Exynos 1080 is an upper mid-range processor and is the successor to the 980. It's a 5nm chipset and will debut by the end of the year on a Vivo-branded smartphone. But here's the interesting part. Dr. Pan, who as I've said is the director of Samsung China R&D, also shared the AnTuTu scores of this Exynos 1080 chipset, and it scored a massive 650,000 points in this benchmarking site. For comparison, the best performing flagship phone right now with Snapdragon 865 Plus scores 615,000 on AnTuTu. So let me get this straight. An upper mid-range processor from Samsung comfortably beats the present highest scoring mobile SoC on the planet, Qualcomm's present flagship, the Snapdragon 865 Plus. Let that sink in for a second. By the way, this isn't just a rumor or some random site claiming these numbers, but it's coming from one of Samsung's executives in China. So this is as legit as it can get. This Exynos 1080 is using Cortex A78 and Mali G78 GPU. So this basically means that the upper mid-range segment next year is going to be very competitive and powerful. Now this left me wondering if an upper mid-range Exynos chip can comfortably beat Qualcomm's latest flagship SoC, then just imagine how well their main flagship Exynos 2100 is going to perform next year on devices like the Galaxy S21 and Note 21. Thankfully, we have some more information about that as well, courtesy of Ice Universe. A few days ago, he said Exynos 2100 may not use Cortex X1 cores, citing this benchmark. Turns out the benchmark was rigged. The Exynos 2100 will surely use the Cortex X1 cores, as pointed out in this new Geekbench benchmark. Also, ARM has named Samsung as their official partner for the X1 cores on their own website, so I was really confused when I said Exynos 2100 will not use X1 cores a few days ago. But good to know that isn't the case. For those unaware, the Cortex X1 is a really powerful core that offers 30% more power than Cortex A77 used by the latest Snapdragon 865 Plus. He also says Exynos 2100 will use Mali G78 MP14 GPU, which he says performs in line with Snapdragon 875's Adreno 660 at 800 MHz, if not better. Now, we still don't know if Qualcomm is going to use Cortex X1 cores on Snapdragon 875. If they use it, then Exynos 2100 and A75 are going to go neck and neck when it comes to performance. ARM has made significant improvements to the Mali GPU as well, and whether or not it performs on par or better than the new Adreno is remains to be seen. But one thing is clear, the days of Exynos lacking behind Snapdragon are behind us, and consumers in Europe and Asia shouldn't feel like they are getting cheated by offering an inferior chipset for the same price. Of course, with that being said, let me know what you think about this down in the comments. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.